I'm going to speak today about the importance of biodiversity and ecosystem services in the spices supply chain. And I'd like to start with the importance of biodiversity in general. And then in the second half of my presentation, I'll focus more on spices and India. Okay, biodiversity, what are we talking about? Biodiversity or biological diversity refers to all forms of life, life from all sources, and also to the diversity of genes, species, and ecosystems. So sometimes biodiversity is confused for just referring to the diversity of species, but it's important to note that it's also about ecosystems and about genes. When I talk about ecosystems, what do I refer to? It's ecosystems. Also, the term also includes the elements, the living and non-living elements it contains, and it includes the occurring relations, interactions, and processes between these elements. Now, probably you've all heard that in the recent decades, we've seen an incredible loss of biodiversity in ecosystems. Yes? I'm hearing some noises. Everything fine? Can you hear and see me?
Yeah, we can hear you. Please go ahead.
Okay. Go ahead. So the dramatic loss of biodiversity in ecosystems, and I would like to share some numbers, some recent numbers here with you. There has been an average fall of 68% in monitored populations of mammals, birds, amphibians, reptiles, and fish between 1970 and 2016. Also, 3/4 of the land and 2/3 of the marine environment have significantly been altered by human actions. 1/3 of the world's topsoils have been degraded, and 32% of the world's forest areas have been destroyed. These are recent numbers. So which are the causes of the loss of biodiversity and ecosystems? The World Economic Forum identified 5 top threats. That's land and sea use change, climate change, natural resource use and exploitation, pollution, and invasive alien species. And all of these threats are driven by humans. So humans have already caused the loss of 83% of all wild mammals and 50% of all plants. And the current rate of extinction is tens to hundreds of times higher than the average over the past 10 million years. So the situation is really dramatic. And why does this matter? One could say, well, biological diversity, nice to have, but does this matter for me, for my livelihood? Yes, it does, definitely, because biological diversity underpins the ecosystem functioning, and thereby it's essential for the provision of ecosystem services and for human well-being. And the ecosystem services, or benefits from nature, as they are called in the graphic you can see here on your right-hand side. Well, usually they are divided into 4 broad categories. The first one is the provisioning services, such as raw materials, fresh water, food. Then we have regulating services, such as climate regulation, water regulation, and pollination. We have supporting services such as nutrient cycling, soil formation, and we also have the cultural benefits, which refer to the recreation and ecotourism, to the aesthetic values of biodiversity, of the ecosystem, for example. Biodiversity is crucial for functioning ecosystems. And the services of nature are also the basis of many economic processes. The loss of biodiversity and ecosystem services poses risks to economic activities and to social development. here are some examples. Loss of productivity, for example, if fish stocks go down, then there's definitely a loss of productivity in fisheries. Raising production costs can be caused, for example, by the loss of pollination services. Then if natural pollination is not in place, there are several examples around the world where pollination had to be done artificially. And well, if you have raising production costs, loss of productivity, also there can be a loss of jobs. The World Economic Forum is saying that more than half of the world's GDP is moderately or highly dependent on ecosystem services. There are calculations are saying that there are $12 trillion of market opportunities lie in achieving the Sustainable Development Goals. And many of these goals are closely related to biodiversity, or rather biodiversity is an underlying layer of these goals. And investing in biodiversity as is also a safeguard to reduce risks for future pandemics, as most likely the current pandemic also has been caused by a zoonosis, and the risk of zoonosis is significantly higher as biodiversity gets destroyed and the contact between wild animals and humans is becoming closer. Coming to the importance of biodiversity in agriculture, biodiversity is key for ecosystem services such as soil and water conservation, maintenance of soil fertility, the protection against pests and diseases through biological control, for pollination, as I already mentioned, and for flood control, just to name some. It ensures the genetic diversity for species, which is important to adapt to changing environments. It ensures also the availability of soil microorganisms, crops and pollinators at species level. And it's particularly important regarding the adaptation to climate change. Now, this slide is seen from a business perspective. Why should businesses pay attention to biodiversity? And it shows that there are risks on the one hand, which can be avoided, and also there are opportunities. The related risks are operational risks, as I already mentioned. This is related to the availability of resources and production factors, but there are also other risks like reputational risks. If you think about newspaper which publishes an article about a certain company destroying rainforest, for example, this is a clear risk for the reputation of the company. You have market-related risks, such as changes in buying behavior and in market prices, regulation and law-related risks, referring to new regulations coming up, for example, related to access and benefit sharing, liability risks. There have been lawsuits against businesses for causing biodiversity loss, and financial market risks, which are that biodiversity criteria are increasingly taken into account for access to financial resources. Now, coming to the opportunities, there's the opportunity to tap new markets, responding to new consumer demands. Product innovation can be based on biodiversity, and new technologies can be developed. Companies can increase their transparency and communicate about the impacts on biodiversity and environment. They might become more attractive as an employer focusing on biodiversity. There might be an opportunity to receive additional income, for example, through premium prices for certified goods. And taking into account biodiversity might also be important for the license to operate, for connecting with local communities. I also would like to share three global tendencies which we've been observing and which underline the importance of taking into account biodiversity. One is the tendency towards standards. There are more than 450 voluntary sustainability standards out there, and they have a growing share within the global production, especially for certain commodities such as coffee or cocoa. And within these standards, also increasing attention is being paid to biodiversity criteria. We also have a rising awareness among consumers and among businesses. And we have a clear trend towards sustainable investment in the financial sector and towards incorporating or taking into account risks of biodiversity. Now I'll come to India and the approach of biodiversity-friendly spice production. Well, there are some challenges for sustainability in spices related to all the aspects I've mentioned before. There have been unsustainable practices which led to contamination of food, water, and soil, which again leads to unsafe working environments for workers. It has a long-term impact on productivity of the farms. There have been cases of reduced earnings due to non-compliance and low quality. Adverse effects are produced on biodiversity, such as reduction on pollinators. And also there have been cases of an inability to access markets owing to food safety issues. All of this shows that there is a challenge, and it's worth to look at sustainability aspects. Now, I'm working, as mentioned in my introduction, I'm working for a global project which is focusing on promoting biodiversity-friendly production and commercialization in three countries, namely Brazil, India, and Mexico, and on different commodities. In India, focusing on spices, in Brazil and Mexico, focusing on other commodities. The program is financed by the German Ministry of Environment, and it started in 2016. In India, we started implementation in 2018. I'd also like to mention key partners for India. On the global level, we've been partnering with global institutions like the Global Nature Fund, Rainforest Alliance, and the Union for Ethical Biotrade. In India, the project is closely linked to the Ministry of Environment, Forests, and Climate Change, and there to the National Biodiversity Authority. And other important partners include the All India Spices Exporters Forum, Spice Board of India, and also PDS Organic Spices, and many others as well. So in India, we decided to conduct a pilot implementation of biodiversity-friendly production and commercialization with a focus on the biodiversity hotspots Western Ghats. And there we focused on the small-scale spice production of pepper, cardamom, nutmeg, cinnamon, and chili. And the main instrument we've been working with are the biodiversity action plans, which help to integrate biodiversity aspects in farms or also in companies. Implementation status, more than 800 farmers and 70 trainers trained. more than 100 pilot implementations with farmers. We conducted biodiversity assessments with 7 major spice exporting companies, and the results of the project have also been integrated into the National Sustainable Spice Program. I mentioned the instruments of biodiversity action plans, and I'd like to share a slide on what is this about. Biodiversity action plans are basically roadmaps that help to plan, implement, and monitor biodiversity actions on farm or in a company. So they start with a baseline assessment. We look at your farm and identify dependencies and impacts. Then based on this, you set certain goals. Based on the goals, measures are selected from a list of measures which is given. These measures are implemented. And then there's a part about monitoring. It's also a special tool we developed to help with the monitoring of the implementation of the measures, but also the monitoring of impacts on biodiversity. These biodiversity action plans look at 2 areas, which you can see here at the right. They look at the protection of existing biodiversity, so rather on conservation measures, but they also look at the continuous reduction of negative impacts, so at farming practices. What is the additional value of these instruments? It provides a hands-on instrument and tools for farmers for biodiversity management. The biodiversity action plans suggest a list of measures which are adapted to local reality. They give ideas on how to monitor implementation, and also they focus on biodiversity management, which is mentioned in many standards but not included in detail. So they give a concrete idea how to do this. Okay, so now I'd like to share some of the results of the approach of biodiversity friendly spice production, which we've been seeing for different stakeholder groups. Well, for farmers, we saw that farmers can improve the provision of ecosystem services, which are crucial for spice production, services such as fresh water, nutrient cycling, pollination, soil fertility. Thereby, the implementation of biodiversity-friendly production measures sustain the economic viability of farm operations. They enhance the resilience of the farm systems, for example, to changing climate conditions and extreme weather events. And oftentimes also, there are better opportunities for commercialization and improved market access. On the cost side, well, costs are difficult to calculate because some of the measures are really low cost and others do include a significant cost. So it depends very much on which measure is taken. For example, depending on the measure, there might even be further opportunities, income opportunities, such as through multi-cropping systems. Okay. For the people living in production areas, clearly the enhanced provision of ecosystem service is a benefit. Ecosystem services there include food supply or also the access to clean and safe water or better quality soil. And there can be a reduction, or there is a reduction of health risks for farm workers and their families because exposure to toxic and persistent chemicals is reduced. For companies can ensure the sustainable production and the continuous supply of spices. They can reduce risks related to biodiversity, such as the reputational risks, market access, and regulation and law related risks. I've been talking before in the general part of my presentation. They can build sound biodiversity management strategies, and biodiversity-friendly spice production also provides business opportunities, such as responding to new consumer demands, product innovation, transparency, and higher prices for products. The instrument of biodiversity action plans also provides an easy way to communicate about biodiversity efforts. And well, costs may include costs for human resources, such as advisors working with the farmers, costs for certification or standard systems, and well, sometimes higher raw material prices. For consumers, we also have benefits relating to health risks, which are minimized by reducing the exposure to toxic and persistent chemicals. And also consumers are given the option to choose products which have lower health risks. Okay, now I'm already coming to the conclusions. Three messages which I would like you to take away from this presentation. Well, the first message, biodiversity and spice production are closely interlinked, as spice production impacts on biodiversity and ecosystem services, and it also depends on biodiversity and ecosystem services. Biodiversity-friendly production brings multiple benefits to farmers, people living in production areas, spice companies, and consumers, as we've seen in the slides I just showed. And the instrument of biodiversity action plans have proven to be hands-on, flexible, and easy to adapt to other contexts, other products as well. If you would like to know more, these are my, here you can see my contact details and also the contact details of my colleague Poonam Pandey in India. Please get in touch if you're interested. And well, I'm also, if there's time, I'm also happy to respond questions, if there are questions from the audience. Thank you very much.